Okay, we're back. Here we have some props from Gina Schwartzman Christiani, Russian-born, but has been in America for a long time, considers herself American now. We have one of her clubs and one of her hat-spinning hats. She's possibly the greatest hat spinner in the world, does two, does pirouettes with two, and just does amazing stuff with that. And wonderful club juggler as well. We have Alexander Kiss, the father of modern Russian juggling, one of the greatest jugglers of all time. Very rare ring from his that he made out of aircraft aluminum. He was an amazing inventor, amazing, amazing juggler. Many of his tricks have never been repeated, even though he was doing them back in the 50s and 60s. He was also the very first juggler to do five club back crosses. Here we have another Russian juggler, Gregory Popovich. We have a club, a ring, and his hat. Does amazing juggling on staying on the top of a freestanding ladder, and also very famous now for his trained cat act, which is an incredible act. We have Vladik Miakostopov, a wonderful juggler who was the juniors champion and the seniors champion for the IJAA back in the 80s and 90s. That was his childhood club, and his father was one of the two Miakostopovs, which this club belonged to, Victor and Anatoly, probably the greatest Russian juggling duo of all time. Here we have a flathead club from the Serafigans, and they put these on table. It stands on a table, and one of the members and is circled by them, and she kicks them to the other members, and they go into passing. That was invented just for them and actually used by them. Here we have Nick Gatto plates. They are wooden plates used by Nick Gatto, the father of the legendary Anthony Gatto. We have three clubs of his here. In the middle is the only existing childhood club of his that his father made. This is what he learned to juggle three clubs with when he was about 5 or 6 years old. Then we have two other performance clubs from him, one from the 80s, which is this one, and then one from the 90s and 2000, which is this one. This next several tables is kind of a timeline of the history of juggling clubs. We have the earliest juggling clubs that were made specifically for juggling by Edward Van Wyck out of Cincinnati, Ohio. This is one that's uncovered. They are hollow. I could go into a lot about their construction, but it is three-piece construction. They're much lighter than a solid piece, solid wood club. So he would make this in a very meticulous process. They would cover the body with glue, wrap it with linen, and then decorate it with Mylar decorations. They started doing that in 1895. And starting in 1919, Harry Lynn became the premier club maker. This is a Harry Lynn club that's never been juggled. It was made, it was put in a box, and was sent to me still in that box. I have four of them. We have the earliest model Harry Lynn club I have, which is from about 1920. And then we have two others from the 50s as well. These are two extremely rare clubs. They're both made by Arthur Mann out of Chicago in the 40s. This is a paper mache club. It has a hardwood dowel that goes to the body of it, and then paper mache made out of newspaper was used to make the body. Here we have another Arthur Mann club, which has a hardwood dowel, a cork knob, an upholstered, painted body stuffed with horsehair, and a metal band, a metal tip right there. Here we have the first modern juggling club made by Jay Green. It's the first club with a cushioned handle and a dense foam knob and end cap. And he made it using this part here is a toy bowling pin, toy plastic bowling pin. So that was all kind of off-the-shelf parts he used. And this is a European model Jay Green, made in the same process with a smaller bowling pin. Here we have a Stu Reynolds club, the first fiberglass clubs. And James started making these in the early to mid '60s, and in the late '60s, Stu Reynolds started making fiberglass clubs. They're a wonderful club. And then we have a Claude Crumley club, which has a wooden dowel, a series of plastic discs, then covered in fiberglass and with a cork end cap. They're very rare. Here we have a Carlo club. Carlo made the very popular book, The Juggling Book by Carlo, and he gave instructions on how to make these clubs, and these are from the late 60s, early 70s. I have a set of three of these, and found in a suitcase in a vintage store in New Jersey. Here we have a very early Dubé multi-piece European club, the first juggling club of this type with the cushion handle and everything that was made using custom molded body. So no toy bowling pin here. That's very early, early one from about 1976. Here we have two clubs made by Rob Leith from Gemini Juggling Company. They're both hollow body. This is the first hollow body European club. And then we have this external decorations, but you can see right inside of that. And this one is a hollow hexagon or octagonal club made by Gemini Juggling. Here we have a Lee Letchworth club made with, he would take a dowel rod and stick it in the mold and fill that with expanding polyurethane foam, and they decorate it and wrap it and everything. And usually they fell apart over time. There are not very many of these left, but I do have one of them there. This is the last remaining Larry Merlo club, kind of the Rolls Royce of toy bowling pin clubs. You would take the toy bowling pin and I would lay that perfect handle and put a knob on there and some end caps, and it's the last remaining one that there is. Here we have the very first Juggle Bug club made by Dave Finnegan. It actually has a wooden dowel, which later ones never had that, and a screw-off knob, which I find very interesting. Next we have an early Dubé one-piece American club. This is the first one-piece plastic club. Here we have a Chinese club from the Shanghai Acrobats from the late 70s. Here we have the first glow-in-the-dark club that actually used glow-in-the-dark plastic rather than a lighted prop. And these two are Ricker clubs made by Rick Bright out in California. They're very similar to Renegade clubs, but slightly different. Here we have a prototype rainbow foam club made by Dave Finnegan. There were only four of these ever made. The other three were used by Ronald McDonald in the Macy's Day Parade. Here we have a Freaks Unlimited Acrobat Club from the United Kingdom. It was the first club to use a plastic dowel. So, they don't make these anymore. And this is from the last batch ever made. Here we have a 10-sided Nikita Club from UK as well, from the company More Balls Than Most. So just interesting shape there. Here we have a lighted club from the 60s. They took a small Indian club, they hollowed it out, put in electronics and a couple AAA batteries and a light bulb and a plastic enclosure, and that was used in a circus act in the 60s. Here we have a soft club made by the Reflection Company of Blacksburg, Virginia. They're very soft. They were very popular for combat juggling when they first came out. Here we have a rattan club with a hardwood dowel used by the Philippine Pride jugglers back in the 1980s. And it's a very nice wicker club. Here we have a radical fish club from Beard Juggling in the UK. Just an interesting shape to it. And you can still buy these. Here we have a Juggle Bug hexagonal club from the early 80s. It looks great, it juggles horribly. This is an important club. This is a Dave Madden club. This is one of the very earliest bowling pin clubs with a, more or less a dowel rod and a crutch tip. And this is what inspired Jay Green to come up with the modern juggling club with the cushion handle. Here we have a wicker club made by Andy Clay of the, I believe that's Andy Clay of the UK, which is the Zuta Juggling Company. And it's a very interesting club there. Very well made. Here we have a Cuphead club made by Renegade Juggling. So you can juggle this and a ball and catch the ball in the cup and interesting things of that sort. Here we have four world records props. We have one of the sticks used by Bruce Tiemann, also known as Boppo, for the first ever 9-stick flash. This is one of those sticks. Here we have one of David Furman's world record balls when he broke the long-standing 10-ball world record when he got 26 catches of 10 balls I think it was 2011, perhaps. Oh, yeah, 2011. And they're very large balls for doing 10 balls. They're a Russian ball. Here's one of my boomerangs that I use for many boomerang world records, boomerang juggling world records, made by Gary Broadbent, of Canton, Ohio area. And then we have a paddle ball, a paddle used by Steve Langley to set a Guinness World Record for the most paddle balls done at the same time.